This is on behalf of a non-Muslim sister. Her question is, there are certain verses in the glorious Quran which, sorry, there are certain verses in the scriptures, the Hindu scriptures, which speak of monotheism, whereas there are some which speak of the opposite. So her question is to quote those verses which are contradicting to monotheism.
This was asked a very good question, that there are verses in the Hindu scriptures which speak about monotheism, which I quoted, but there are verses which speak exactly the opposite about many gods. So why don't I quote that? As I mentioned, that the most highest in authority amongst all the Hindu scriptures, it is the Ved. And the Ved basically speaks about monotheism. There are other scriptures which are lower down in authority, which do speak about pantheism, which do speak about polytheism, but as a logic, if there's a contradiction, we follow the higher thing. And what I mentioned in my formula, I said what is differing we'll discuss tomorrow. So even if there is a verse of polytheism, there's no verse of polytheism in the Quran. So that goes out. We are talking about that which is common. And logically, how can Almighty God contradict? How can Almighty God say in one place there's one God, other place there are many gods? That means there's a contradiction, and if there's a contradiction, it cannot be the word of God. So then it is a Hindu to decide that how can they follow a scripture which has got contradiction. Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, verse 82, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ دِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُ فِي اخْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا. Do they not consider the Quran with care? Had it been from anyone besides Allah, had it been from anyone besides Allah, there have been many contradictions, there have been many mistakes. So how can a word of God have contradiction? So if there are contradictions, you have to reject that scripture. It's easy. And if you follow my formula, I'm taking only that which is common. I can give a longer speech talking about differences in Islam and Hinduism. But I have not come here to bring the differences. I am come here to get the similarities. Because Almighty God says in the Quran how to speak with other people. In Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 64, we say, تَعَلَوْ إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَ بَيْنَكُمْ. Come to common terms as between us and you. Which is the first term? Allah na'budu illa Allah. That we worship none but Allah. وَلَا نُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْئًا. That we associate no partners with Him. وَلَا يَتَّخِذَ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا أَرْبَابًا مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. That we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا. If then they turn back. فَقُولُوا شَهَدُوا. Say, ye bear witness. بِأَنَّا مُسْلِمُونَ. That we are Muslims bowing our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is a formula shown in the Quran how to speak with different types of people. That come to common terms. Differences we can discuss tomorrow. Today we come to common terms and let us agree to follow what is common. So I am picking up those verses which are matching with the Quran. If there is a contradiction, I reject that scripture. I don't consider it to be the word of God. But because the Hindus consider it to be the word of God, I am quoting from the scriptures. Hope that answers the question, sister.